First fire up of the day. Let me see something. Set the radio up. Okay. Bam, just like that. Okay. No sound as of yet. We're just now, testing a few things just to make sure that we are in the game. Let me see something. Make sure my hand controls are functioning and stuff. All right, move that there. Make sure my volumes is working right. Volumes, there, okay. Okay, yeah. So we're gonna get on. Got the wiring already set up. He sent me the battery, but turned out to be the battery with the opposite side poses. I got a call for that. But yeah, we're gonna have some sound today. Well, today is the day. We got it in, wired, nice and neat. Exit here, jump over here, and out, over here, over there. Shut that one down. Just mount the amp on the wall, a few small things. Got the, deck in. Everything's functioning over here. Let's see what's up here. I'm gonna back it out the driveway, put it on the street, and give a listen to it in a second. Wait for it to see the flash drive, and we'll have action. Wait for it, format read, here we go. Well, here we go again. Got the 2000, looks to be a 18 or so. 19, it'll have a different radio, so it's going to be 18. Because it's a 17 or 18 because of the motor. But yeah, it's a pretty nice bike, you know. We did some little extra stuff that the man saw that I was doing and said, hey, Rob, put me on. So we put him on. You know, a little bit of this, a little bit of that. I'm only one person with one hand, so yeah. So that's what we ended up doing there. We just got to mount a few things down and we'll be straight. Underneath the seat game is straight, you know, real simple hook up there. We got a Pioneer Media Center up in here, so which gives you Apple CarPlay and things of that nature. So let's let it play. He said, walk back a little bit, Rob. It doesn't matter what time of the day. Ask me what I'm doing. And it's you that I'm gonna say. We'll give it a few howls. 24/7, 2365. So I figure he good with that, you know. Just wanted you to know how you stay on my mind. It's about 8:05, curfew about to kick in. When they talking about, you know, 8:30, gotta be in the house. It's all good. But yeah, I think this is good enough. Let them know Money's Car Stereo is in the building. Especially if you're playing something that's user friendly. He said he might go 2.0. I don't know. We'll see. I think this is pretty good. And I don't wanna let go. Just keep on holding on. Oh, you got me going. Thoughts of me and you.
Thanks all those who have been yawning. Kids from foreign coming over in an early morning. It's other than Gaga with them car and leave. Mr. Lux with the girls, them watch them on the side of me. On a remix tip.
The wickedest time, me and me girl a come. Banjo Americans, pretty place to. Now put it down, gang. Papa make it and again. Sometimes coffee, sometimes tea. You know, say Banjo Americans a celebrity. We ram dance at home and in the country. Whoa. Look how the girls, them nice and sweet. The glimity, glamity way, hey, and the neat. We want it every day, not to mention the weed.
Reggae music run the world, irrespect that. Cause every time we touch the mic, them screaming boom, shakata. Road a massive gets the vibes, we an orthodox. This is a lesson, definition of the boom, shakata. No.
Once again, Money is Car Stereo. To be continued. Let's get finish up these last few things and get this back to the owner. That's right. We dropping off in a city near you. Gotta go. Well, all the final details of cleaning up stuff. Getting rid of. Okay, as they say, it's all in the details. So we pretty much finished it yesterday. Just going back through it, testing a few things, getting rid of any excess glue, you know, and getting ready to ship out tomorrow or the next day. Just letting you see what I see, you know. That's pretty much it. Gotta go. Due to my neighbors help me out.
The piggy character? That's the bunny. Here's a killer bunny. Too.
We cleaned him up. So he's a lot more shinier than what he was. Put him on a truck ride home. Like I said, I don't detail, but you know, I at least put it back how I found it. Gotta go. I don't normally wash people bikes, but this bike got real dirty. So I'ma pretty much clean it up and put it away. Seeing as how we got storage, not issues, construction issues going on at my spot, so we need to go ahead and clean it up, you know, because it was half-ass dirty when it got here, but it just got more dirty due to the construction. So let's give it a little bit of something so it won't be totally jacked when he gets it back. Less of the maintenance. I'm just saying, my car stereo. Don't call me detail man, because that's not my job. Gotta go. This is why it's good to have a truck. Like this. Because you can get a bike in the back of it real easy. If you go in places and you don't feel like riding your bike, I'm gonna tell you why, I'll show you why. To me, it's important to have an 8-foot bed truck. The 6-foot bed is good. An 8 is better. So we're going down here.
air out of it.
Good to have a wheel chock also. But the key thing to this whole party is this. When you're a solo operation, and you don't have a lot of family members or friends around to help you, it's always good. It's always awesome to have a 3-wide trailer. I mean, 3-wide ramp. Because you're about to see, the key thing is line it up, to center it with this right here. Wheel chock, walk through. Good. As long as you don't get nervous and slip up on your clutch hand, everything should go fine. Let's see. See, so with the 8-foot bed, you can pretty much do like what I'm doing right now, which is tag it and bag it. And from there, you go ahead and strap it on in. Let's see something here. Bam, bam, bam. Yeah, so put some air back in the air shocks, it'll smooth out the ride, and we good to go. So, one man show, check everything, and we're good. That part right there.